Now, National Party MP Simon Bridges is walking away from politics after 14 years. So why now and what next? Well, who better to hear it from than Simon Bridges? Thanks for joining us this morning.
Hey, kia ora, Melissa. Thanks for having me on.
Kia ora. Well, you know, this is what happened yesterday. You announced your resignation. Then I hear that Ryan is off with COVID. And then I hear you saying that you've got some media projects in the line. You know, joining the dots. I can only see that you just want to be here on the desk with us.
Well, look, I can but aspire. I mean, the reality is you guys have... it's probably your fault that I have delusions of media aspirations, but I have deeply appreciated being on AM. And, you know, it's been great for me actually to be on TV and talking about things that matter and having a bit of fun. So I've really appreciated it. But look, for me, I mean, to answer your question earlier, it's just time. I've loved being an MP. It's been a massive privilege. I still love it actually. And I have some sadness, but I'm also excited about, you know, some new opportunities for me. And, you know, I'm 45, so I'm not exactly old, I'm not exactly a young. My oldest two out of three turned 10 and 8 this week. And so for me, you know, it's about sort of putting them first and doing a few new things.
Okay, so what are those commercial opportunities? You've clearly got a job lined up.
I'm not going to give detail today, you know, as I work through those things. But, you know, I suppose what is true is you end up getting unique, in quotes, skills as a member of parliament and as a minister and in opposition. And so, you know, the chance to kind of put those into commercial practice would be good. And then in terms of media projects, you know, that's fun. And, I mean, it's no secret I've enjoyed writing a book and doing a bit of writing. Politics was before I became a member of parliament my hobby, in a way. It's something I love. And so to be able to talk about some of that stuff, you know, will be, as I say, pure fun for me.
Okay, so we're talking kind of political commentary, perhaps some writing, perhaps a little bit of entertainment TV?
you're getting warmer. You're getting warmer.
Ah, okay.
But you know, I hope there'll be some serious, there'll be some contribution, and then there'll also be a bit of fun. And I've said too much, and I hope you can find a way for us to conveniently change the topic.
What do you like on the old Twinkle Toes?
No, I will dispel all rumours of Dancing with the Stars. There is zero chance. I've learned over time that it's okay to humiliate yourself to an extent, but you have to have some basic level of natural talent or skill, and that's not an area where you'll be seeing me.
Okay. Now, what will you spill the beans on? Because we've read, you know, a lot about your story through your book, obviously. But this all came before Judith Collins demoted you last year. And at the time you said, I have a huge amount I want to say about what happened yesterday and how wrong it was. And I assure you I will. So it's your time. What would you like to tell us?
Well, I think at the end what happened there in terms of a change of leadership meant that, much of what, you know, in a sense needed to be said when there was one leader didn't need to be said when there was a new one. I mean, I'm very excited for Chris Luxon. I think there's a real opportunity for us to win the next election. In a sense, what I'm doing is not about National, it's personal, but what is also true is I'm really grateful that I'm able to leave at a time when National is, it has got some momentum, and, you know, in a small way, I feel some pride in having played a role in that and getting us back into a position where it's going to be a really competitive election, I think, in 2023.
Yeah, and we've heard about, you know, your work with a couple who were going through surrogacy issues. We've heard about the impact you've had in infrastructure that you're very proud of, but you must have some regrets or some low points that you would rather not have gone through in your career in politics.
You know, there's definitely been highs and there's definitely been lows. But, you know, and I'm not just saying this because it sounds nice. I genuinely, firmly believe it and have come to believe it strongly. I wouldn't swap out the lows. I mean, I think they
what
teach
the
you a
lows?
Lot about yourself and who you are. Well, you know them. and I think in the highlight reels by Jenna Lynch on the news last night, you got some of them, you know. But they were all there. They're good material for national identity. Too, my next book out 2 months before the election. No, not really. But
well,
but I
maybe you said you wanted to do some writing.
I wouldn't swap them out. It's been a privilege. I've enjoyed it all, and I actually thought about when I was, you know, getting ready to come out and say, you know, I am leaving, whether I'd sort of say, you know, I've lost my mojo a bit and so on. But actually, what I realised is that's not true. I still have fire in my belly. I still love politics, and I will miss this place we're standing in right now. But you know, in a pros and cons sense about what's right for me and my family, it was time.
What were your children like last night? How did they react, your family?
They're excited. They're really excited. And I think, you know, the youngest doesn't quite know what it all means, but the older two definitely do. And the reality is, and I'm not complaining, it's been a privilege, but for members of parliament and for all of my kids' lives, I've been away. You know, you go away on a Monday and oftentimes you're back a Thursday or possibly a Friday. And so there's a luxury in being in your own bed, waking up sometimes with the kids probably trying to kick me out of that bed and get close to mum. And yeah, I'm really looking forward to doing that, not just sort of two or three nights a week, but seven.
Your departure leaves, I would say, though, an even wider diversity gap with the National. Do you think that that's going to be an issue for the party?
I think the reality of that, Melissa, is that is a product of the last election, and let's face it, a poor election result for National, which meant, yeah, you're right, in the end, we didn't have the diversity that we would want. I'm a firm believer that will be fixed at the next election. I mean, I think, you know, if I do say so myself, you know, what happens is you're not the Member of Parliament that you were on day one on the 14th year. And so, you know, I build up a lot of experience. But what I do know is in politics, you know, whether it was a young me or, you know, it's Chris Luxon or whoever it is, where there's gaps, there isn't a vacuum. Actually, new people come in, they get the experience and the skills and they bring the diversity and the talent that's required. And National's very good and has been very good over its life at doing that and reforming and changing and recreating itself.
Talking about recreating, we are talking this morning because of your retirement from politics about dream careers and what people would do if they were going to have a complete change in career. What would be your dream? You know, moving from politics, if you could say, I'm going to do anything, what is it?
I have some unrequited sort of desires. And one is, having said that I'm no dancer, I had megalomaniac desires as a young child to be the conductor of a symphonic orchestra. I sense even at the young age of 45 that is probably too late, but that's one. I also have this closet desire that I have talked about a little in my life. I still do see the possibility as an older New Zealander one day of some cranky talkback show, sort of maybe from midnight to 6 a.m. for those who can't sleep. So that one I think is rather more realistic than the symphony orchestra.
National Party MP Simon Bridges, we love having you on the show. I'm sure we're going to see you again shortly, perhaps later on this week. We love your sparring sessions with David Parker, of course, so we'll hopefully see you then. Thanks very much for your time.
Hey, thanks very much for having me on. Cheers, Melissa.